this video, we will be showing how we can force all teams to have a continuous attacking style. Let's take a look at the objective of soccer. The objective of soccer is to attack when we are in possession of the ball and to defend when not in possession of the ball, so that the team with the highest goals ends up victorious. That is called a winning mentality. Now, it is the duty of the laws that govern the game of soccer to force all teams to have this winning mentality. That is, attack when they have the ball and defend when they don't have the ball. Now, this can only be done by equality. This is so because in our present day soccer, some teams go into the game with their selfish objective of wanting just a draw out of the game, and a draw may be goalless. So they choose to play defensive throughout the game without playing attacking. While others go into the game with the fair mentality of being attacking and defensive, but once they have a 1-0 lead over their opponent, they choose to play defensive for the rest of the match. Now that is boring and destroys the entertainment of the game. What if we can force all these teams to have this winning mentality, that is attacking continuously and defending continuously for the 90 minutes of the game? For example, if we have the probability of attacking and defending in the game to be 50-50, so much so that we cannot choose to defend without attacking, nor attack without defending, we see that we are going to eliminate the issue of choice, thereby forcing all teams to have this winning mentality. This is the same like in the case where we have two pens which are equal. We see that choosing one is the same as choosing the other, hence we have no choice as to which to choose. Let us take another example in a game of basketball. In the game of basketball, you can never see a team choosing to play defensive for the rest of the game. This is so because the game of basketball is based on equality. And with this mentality, all teams are forced to play attacking when they have the ball and to defend when they don't have the ball. In the present day soccer, which was not created based on equality, we see that the probability to defend is far, far greater than the probability to attack, which is 90:10. Now, when the probability to defend and to attack are not the same, we now have the issue of choice coming into the game. That's why we see some teams choosing to play defensive throughout the match and yet achieve their goal, which is the same in a scenario where we have like two pens which are not equal. We see that we can decide to always choose this blue pen, as one can also decide to always choose the red pen. That means in this case we have choice to make. But we want to create a soccer in which we will not be liable to making choice. That is, we are compelled to attack whenever we have the ball and defend when we don't have the ball. And this is the idea of Coach Pendy, to bring in equality into the game, which will eliminate the aspect of choice, thus compelling all teams to have that continuous attacking mentality when they have the ball and to defend when they don't have the ball, which will, by so doing, stimulate enough movement into the game and thus increasing the number of goals in a game of soccer.